instance in which the common people of any land have ever declared themselves in favor of a gold standard. You come to... pages of history in vain to find a single instance in which the common people of any land have ever declared themselves in favor of a gold standard. You come to us and tell us that the great cities are in favor of the gold standard. I tell you that the great cities rest upon these broad and fertile prairies. Burn down your cities and leave our farms, and your cities will spring up again as if by magic. But destroy our farms, and the grass will grow on the streets of every city in this country. My friends, we shall declare that this nation is able to legislate for its own people on every question without waiting for the aid or consent of any other nation on earth. Upon that issue, we expect to carry every single state in this union. It is the issue of 1776 over again. Our forefathers, when but 3 million, had the courage to declare their political independence of every nation on earth. Shall we, their descendants, when we have grown to 70 million, declare that we are less independent than our forefathers? No, my friend, it shall never be the judgment of this people. Therefore, we care not upon what lines the battle is fought. They say that bimetallism is good, but we cannot have it until some other nation helps us. We reply that instead of having a gold standard because England has, we shall restore bimetallism, and then let England have bimetallism because the United States has. If they dare to come out in the open and defend the gold standard as a good thing, we shall fight them to the uttermost, having behind us the producing masses of this nation and the world, having behind us the commercial interests and the laboring interests and all the toiling masses. We shall answer their demands for a gold standard by saying to them, you shall not press down upon the brow of labor this crown of thorns. You shall not crucify mankind upon a cross of gold.